Hello everyone, welcome to Historically Accurate. In 98 BC, the Han Dynasty, a middle-aged male prisoner was being taken to the execution chamber by the jailer. His face was calm, his eyes were bright, and he didn't look at all like he was about to be castrated. Because he knew that this was his own choice. Before finishing his work, he couldn't die, so he had no choice but to accept the emperor's terms, castration instead of the death penalty. Who is this man? He is the protagonist of this episode, Sima Qian. It is said that Sima Qian's ancestors had been court historians since the Zhou Dynasty. Sima Qian's father, Sima Tan, held the position of Taishi, court historian and astrologer in the Han Dynasty. So Sima Tan felt that it was a great honor to write and revise the history and calendar for the country, and he also hoped that his son would become a court historian in the future. Sima Tan attached great importance to Sima Qian's education. At the age of 10, Sima Qian had already studied the famous ancient books at that time, Shang Shu, records of the conversations of ancient kings and ministers, Zuo Zhuan, a chronicle of the pre-Qin period, and Guo Yu, a history book recording various events of various vassal states. When Sima Qian was 20 years old, his father asked him to travel around the country, collect historical stories, and explore local customs. Sima Qian's footprints spread all over the Jianghuai and Central Plain regions. After the travel, he was sent by the emperor to the south of Ba and Shu to plan the establishment of new counties. More than 2,000 years ago in China, the vast majority of people didn't have the opportunity to learn to read, nor would they ever have the opportunity to travel more than 50 kilometers away from their hometown in their lifetime. While Sima Qian, who was less than 30 years old, not only read and studied various ancient books, but also traveled almost over half of the country. Such a unique experience played a huge role in his future writing of Shiji, Records of the Grand Historian. In 110 BC, Sima Tan fell seriously ill. Before he passed away, he told Sima Qian that he hoped Sima Qian could write a book about the complete history of China. This was the goal that Sima Tan had always wanted to achieve, but didn't get a chance to work on it. This idea was the original prototype of Shiji, which was now passed down to his own son by Sima Tan. After the death of Sima Tan, Sima Qian was appointed as Taishi and succeeded his father. This gave him access to more historical materials in the national collection. While doing his own job, Sima Qian recorded the important events in the country and helped Emperor Wu of Han to make a new calendar. At the same time, he sorted out these scattered historical materials and prepared to write Shiji. While Sima Qian was carrying out his work smoothly, he got involved in an incident. In 99 BC, Emperor Wu of Han sent Li Guangli, the elder brother of his favorite concubine, Lady Li, and Li Ling, a general, to attack the Huns. Li Guangli commanded the main force of 30,000 cavalry and killed more than 10,000 Huns. But he also lost 60 to 70% of his troops. Cavalries were invaluable to the farming empire. I have talked about the reason in my previous episode about the Great Wall. Please check it out if you are interested. Li Guangli's battle can be regarded as a failure. And Li Ling, who led 5,000 infantrymen, encountered the main force of the Huns. Li Ling led several bloody battles with the Huns and also killed more than 10,000 enemy troops. In the end, because there was no food and arrows, he asked his soldiers to break through separately and surrendered himself to the Huns. Later, Emperor Wu of Han mistakenly thought that Li Ling, who had surrendered to the Huns, was training troops for the Huns, so he ordered the killing of Li Ling's whole family. At this time, no one in the entire court spoke up for Li Ling, except for Sima Qian. He came forward, compared the result of Li Ling's battle with the result of Li Guangli's battle, and defended Li Ling's surrender to the Huns. As a result, Emperor Wu of Han thought that Sima Qian was satirizing his mistake in using Li Guangli, who lost the battle, and he also wanted to kill the family of the hero. This made Emperor Wu of Han extremely angry. He not only insisted on killing Li Ling's family, but also sentenced Sima Qian to death. In the early Han Dynasty, people sentenced to death could get away with it by paying 500,000 copper coins, or by accepting castration instead. Sima Qian had wanted to die unflinchingly, but he couldn't just die like this because he wanted to finish his book. Unfortunately, his family didn't have that much money. He had to endure humiliation and be castrated in exchange for the chance to finish writing his book. So, the scene at the beginning of this episode happened. After Sima Qian was castrated, he spent years painstakingly searching for historical materials, revising the materials and writing. Shi Ji, the history book that has been quoted many times in my videos, was finally completed. This is the first general history of China written in biographical style, with 130 chapters and 520,000 words. So what is biographical style? It is a writing style in which historical events are documented by describing the words, deeds, and activities of each individual famous person in the history. Many history books record historical events in chronological order, but it is difficult for this recording method to reflect the characteristics and personalities of the people involved in the events. By recording events based on historical figures and by comparing multiple persons participating in the same event, we can observe the same event from different perspectives. Since Shi Ji, the official historical books of China's various dynasties, have all been written in biographical style. So what exactly does Shi Ji record? It records more than 3,000 years of history from the age of the Yellow Emperor to the reign of Emperor Wu of Han at that time. Chapters of Shi Ji are categorized into five groups: Ben Ji, basic annuals; Biao, tables; Shu, treatises; Shi Jia, hereditary houses; and Lie Zhuan, biographies. Ben Ji records the deeds of the rulers. Biao lists the sequence of events in tabular form. Shu records the relevant system of rites, music, astronomy, and geography, etc. Shi Jia records the events of aristocrats who acquire their titles by hereditary means. Lie Zhuan describes the various deeds of many important figures in history. For example, the famous assassins and the knights errant introduced in biographies of assassins and the biographies of knights errant in Shi Ji are the origin of Chinese xiake culture. I talked about this in a previous video, and if you are interested, please check it out. The narrative in Shi Ji is quite captivating, and the characters are vividly depicted. For example, in history, Xiang Yu was the most important opponent of Liu Bang, the founder of the Han Dynasty. Although Xiang Yu failed in the end, Sima Qian still specifically wrote about Xiang Yu in Ben Ji, which records the deeds of the rulers. In the Ben Ji of Xiang Yu, Sima Qian described many exciting scenes in Xiang Yu's life. For example, in the process of overthrowing the Qin Dynasty, as the deputy general of the uprising army, he saw that the commanding general, Song Yi, didn't show any concern for the soldiers and didn't care about the lives of the other uprising armies. Xiang Yu resolutely killed Song Yi and led the uprising army to fight against the Qin army himself. In the end, he also led 50,000 elite troops to defeat the 200,000 main forces of Qin army in the Battle of Julu, which laid the foundation for the victory of the anti-Qin war. Various additions were made to Shi Ji by others since its completion, and the contents in Shi Ji can't be 100% accurate. But precisely because of such a magnificent work, the main line of the history of Chinese civilization was passed down in ancient times, when information was extremely difficult to be preserved, so that future generations can understand what the ancient Chinese civilization was really like. I am very grateful to those who recorded the history. Okay, that's all for this episode. If you have any suggestions or ideas, please leave a comment down below to discuss with me. See you next time!